We are beginning tonight with some shaken nerves on the Central Coast.
We've had three significant earthquakes over the past 24 hours, along with a lot of aftershocks.
Tonight, a 3.7 followed by a 3.9 quake, just 6 minutes apart, both centered in the exact same location near San Juan Bautista. People felt the jolts from all over the Central Coast. No injuries or significant damage reported.
And it all comes on the heels of the strongest quake we've had recently. It happened just before 1 o'clock in the morning. A 4.5 also centered near San Juan Bautista.
Action News reporter Stephanie Truong is live in Salinas with more.
Well, guys, you were in the newsroom when we got the flood of calls from people in Watsonville, Hollister, to Monterey. Many of them wondering if the small quakes signify that a bigger one's to come. So we asked an expert.
October 17, 1989, the scene inside a UC Santa Cruz class. It's what so many on the Central Coast remember, the Loma Prieta earthquake. The magnitude 6.9 quake devastated the area, its epicenter near the Santa Cruz Mountains. It's also why, when we have three significant earthquakes within 24 hours, people start to worry, wondering if these smaller quakes are a precursor to something much bigger. The experts say no.
For a magnitude 4 earthquake, the possibility of something societally significant, like a 6.5 in the next week, is something like 1 in 1,000. So it's not zero, but it's not a very probable event.
The Central Coast has been rocking. A 4.5 measured early Wednesday morning and a 3.7 and 3.9 at around 8 at night. The epicenters within just a few miles of each other between Salinas and Hollister near the junction of the San Andreas and Zayanti fault lines. It made plenty of people nervous.
How long it's going to last or... how strong going to be? Do I need to get up or get out of the house?
The first 5 seconds, I was like, whoa, cool, earthquake, right? And then, you know, after like 10 seconds, I kind of got up and like got in the doorway just to make sure nothing happened.
So while according to the experts, there are no real predictors of when something like Loma Prieta may hit again, any quake or even a series that gets our attention is a good reminder to always be prepared.
What's the first thing you do?
Get in the doorway, go outside, hide under a table, whatever can protect you from falling debris.
Now, the expert we spoke with tonight, Dr. Brodsky, says that, you know, reminds us that these kind of earthquakes happen every day in California. It just so happens that these happened in a place where people could feel them. So some other tips to consider are an evacuation plan, disaster kits, and, of course, what we learned in school, drop, cover, and hold on, guys.
All right. Very good. Thanks.
All right. Thank you, Stephanie. There have been more than 30 aftershocks since the first quake in San Juan Bautista early this morning. Most have been very, very mild, 1.0 to 2.5, but a few have been a tad stronger.
There's a lot more on the earthquakes on our website. You can sound off on our Facebook page, too. Share your story with Action News. So far, we've gotten well over 100, nearly 125 comments just in the past couple of hours.